So for our case study today, we choose the tooth 2-1 in incisal with some problems that we have here, less space for our layering. Another thing why we used in this case ceramic is that we have a discolorated tooth. And for these cases, it's mostly better you use a metal ceramic instead of a full ceramic crown, because you get a better coverage of this discoloration of the tooth. In fact, what we do is we use our CAD-CAM system, and so we build up our metal coping, and then we start layering with a VMK Master to get the most perfect aesthetic result in the whole oral field. So here we have the actual situation of the patient. We see the preparation of the dentist. And if we have a close look to the incisal, we can see that the dye is standing a little bit forward to the labial side. So what we try now is to mask the situation with the first layer with luminaries on the opaque. So now we start with a luminary firing. In this case, we have a 3M2, so we use the LM2. Luminary materials are highly fluorescent, and they support the natural fluorescency of the tooth, and you have a good control to get the right fluorescency in your crown. Then we mix it with a modeling liquid RS, that stands for red solution, and this enables us to get a long time modeling period. So the next step now is the application of the luminary material. In this case, with the luminary material 2, we add a natural fluorescency on the incisal edge and to mask the coping. Please apply the luminary material in a really thin layer. You can put it here on the approximate areas as well. And then you can structure the luminary appliance to get more an indifferent reflection of the light. After a short drying period, you can individualize your luminary structure to get more indifferent light breaking into your crown, especially in the incisal edge. So this is the next step, and this is even the main step, that we apply the dentin. In this case here, we have the color 3M2, and we apply the dentin in the whole shape. So after finishing the labial side, we fix the approximate ridges. In this case here, the distal one and the mesial one. The tissue we use for drying the ceramic. And with the next step, we're building up some ridges. The VMK Master has this big advantage that we have a really low shrinkage rate. So that means that we don't have to oversize the crown a lot. As you can see it here, we oversize it only a little bit in the incisal edge. We turn around the model and we're having a look at the parallel side. In this case, really important the view from the incisal edge to see how far we get outside with this crown. The palatal modulation is really easy because we apply only a thin layer of ceramic with a dentin in this case here. And with the next step, we're building up some ridges. Be careful, because normally the patients don't like extreme modulated palatal sides. Short view back to the labial area, and now we create our incisal edge with the dentin again. So here we have a short overview over the crown, which we modulated in dentin. It's really important to have a look at the crown at different angles to see the correct shape. So what we create now is some cuts, and with these cuts in different depths we create a different reflection of the light. Here we have the mixed powders for the enamel layering. EN1 enamel. Then we have the T1 white transparent. Really nice material for approximate ridges, for example. Then we have the T4. T4 is a replacement for the enamel in the incisal edge. It has a higher translucency. And what I really like is the T6, the blue one for the incisal approximate ridges. Window, one of the dangerous materials because it's really clear. And the last one what we got here is a PLT1, it's a pearl translucent. So here we have an individual styled patterns for this materials, like T1, T4, T6, or the OT1 and PLT1. So it is really helpful if you use these patterns, because they show you exactly where you have to place your materials and in which intensity it comes out after the firing. So here we go with a incisal creating. We use first the T6, the blue one. Be careful with the blue one, use it only in a really thin layer, otherwise it's getting too bluish. And then you can put it again in the middle of the crown, but always in a really thin layer if you apply the T6. Mostly what I put in between is some T4 to get a higher contrast between the blue material and the transparent material. For the approximate ridges, then mostly I use the T1 because it's milky. And you can also create in the incisal edge with a milky some white spots or brighter spots, so you get a better result and a better contrast in between all these layers. The main reason for building up these different layers in the incisal edge is that the light interaction is more complete, and it's really for the light reflection of the tooth. It's really important that you use different layers. PLT1, it's a pearl translucent for some pearl effects on the surface. The central part of the tooth we build up is a enamel, in this case EN1, matches really perfect the 3M2. And this is really important that you use in this case is always a thin layer of enamel. And for the incisal edge and the central part, the central incisal part, we use really a thin layer of window to create more depth in our crown. So the last step before we go to the furnace with the crown for the first firing, we adjust the surface. That means we create some texture on the surface, and this is really important to do it with a brush, because in this case when we try to do the crown in one firing, in a one firing strategy, we try to create our surface texture only with a brush, and then we don't have to grind it after the firing. So after the finish of the modulation
of my incisal crown, I go back to the furnace. And now this is really important that you calibrate your furnace, because it can only fire what you set in there, but it's really important that the furnace has the right temperature, what the ceramic needs. So you have to calibrate it. You can calibrate it by yourself in doing it with a pattern of window material. And so you can exactly see that you get the right temperature in your furnace. First firing. So again, just a short control so that you get the right temperature, and then press the start button. So now you see the result after the first firing. A really nice aspect is that you can see all the surface textures, what we build up with the brush before the firing, and you can see them after the firing as well. That means that the VMK Master has a low shrinkage rate, which enables us to build up these crowns in only one bake. Even the approximate contact areas are perfect as far as you can see it, and this is for us a really big advantage. And the only thing what I have to do now is fixing or adjusting my surface. And that's what I do in the beginning with a diamond in shape of a flame. So the last step is the glaze firing. It's not necessary to paint the crown because VMK Master lives from its natural brilliancy. The only thing what we do is that we do some accents on the surface. Means in the incisal edge, for example, creating a small halo. Some small accents is a better way to create a really natural looking crown, but please, don't paint the crown. So at the end, my personal conclusion about the VMK Master. What I really like on this material is the easy and safe handling and the brilliant colors. Another point is the really good shrinkage rate, which enables me to bake a lot of single crowns in only one bake, and it's for me really important.
Life, 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 life.